Today, we are going to work in one of the most feared tabs inside DaVinci Resolve, which is the Fusion tab. We're going to do the work for this green screen shot, and then we're going to finish it in the Color tab in DaVinci Resolve. The first thing I'm going to do is take my footage and put it in the media pool inside DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to change the frame rate, and then we're going to create a timeline. This is a very simple shot because we want to do just the basics inside Fusion. Think about this as your first green screen practice. So we're going to do this as easy as possible. Right click into this clip and then click into new Fusion clip. Now this is a Fusion clip that I can go inside Fusion and start modifying it. These are the nodes. Think about nodes as if they were tasks. This task tells DaVinci to import a certain material, which is this video. And this task says DaVinci that this is going to go into the Edit tab, or also the Color tab. If I disconnect this node, what I'm going to see in the Edit tab is this, absolutely nothing. So every time that I do anything inside Fusion, I need to have an input into the media out. And everything that I'm going to do is going to be between these two main tasks. So now I need a node or a task that takes out all of this green screen. I'm going to press Shift Space and look for the 3D keyer. Here it is. I click on it and click on Add. If it doesn't connect automatically, what you can do is just click and drag the effect, and while pressing Shift in the keyboard, just put it in the middle and it's going to get connected right away. Up here, I've got two viewers, and I can assign this node to this viewer by just dragging it out here. And I'm going to drag this one out here. Right now, they look the same. But what I want to do is go into my keyer, click on the picker, and click and drag within all my shot. I need to select everything that is green in this shot. And as you can see, it is almost done. Go inside here. If you don't see this inspector, you can just click right here and it's going to appear. Click on the effect and we're going to click and drag the spill all the way up to 1. And as you can see, it is already solved. If we go into the Edit tab, we're going to see our footage with the transparency. Remember that the transparency in Fusion looks like this checkerboard, and the transparency inside the Edit page looks absolutely black, as well as in the Color tab. We're going to get back into the Fusion tab, and I need a background. So what I'm going to do is click and drag my footage into the media pool, click and drag into the flow. And now I need that this is behind this footage. Take the outside of what will be my foreground and click, drag and drop into the output of what will be my background. And now I've got a merge, and this merge has to be connected to the input of the media output. But here's a big problem. The resolution of this media is dictating the final output. So this composition right now is 1920 by 1080, while my original footage was Ultra HD. So I need to change this media. Click on my media, and now that it's selected, I'm going to Shift Space and look for the resize. And if it doesn't connect, just Shift Drag and drop right here. So what this resize is doing is giving my footage a new size, which is now of 3840 by 2160, which is Ultra HD. And now it's time to finish it all up in the Color tab. I always like to add some default anchors, select the blue curves, and just drag just a little bit in the highlights. And do the same, but in the shadows of the reds. I'm gonna click here, and I think that's too much. So I'm going to add another anchor right here. And I just want to pull just a little bit, just enough for this texture to be a little bit greenish. So that's perfect for me. I can also add a vignette, but what I don't want to do is do like the same vignette as always. So I don't want to do this, because if I do this, my main character is going to be shadowed by the vignette, and I don't want that. I want the vignette to act in favor of my character, not against it. So what I can do is just do this. And now my character is not shadowed by this vignette. This is too much. I'm going to increase the exposure just a little bit. This is before and this is after. And this looks great. Maybe I can also drag a little bit more the feather. So that's perfect. Now that I realized this shot needs a little bit more of blur in the background. So that's no problem because we're still in DaVinci Resolve. So I can just get back into the Fusion tab, select resize, add this effect, which is the blur. And now I click and drag here. And yeah, this is too much. I just need a little bit. This is the before and this is the after. That's enough for me. I get back into the Color page. Everything is right here. And maybe just as the final thing, I'm going to add another node. Go into my curve, select just the luma, add default anchors, and give it a little toe in the dark areas. Just enough to have this washed out effect. which I actually like sometimes. And yeah, this is the before, this is the after. This is our scene in the original stage, and this is already with the fusion and color effects. As you can see, it is not that complicated, as now as you already know the tools that are within Fusion. So that means that you just have to practice over and over and over again and watch a bunch of tutorials, to be honest. But hey, that's where the fun is. Let me know in the comments what kind of tools do you want to see inside Fusion, inside DaVinci Resolve, in the color tab, in the edit tab. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and this footage is from ArtGrid.io. They are not sponsoring this video, but you can find an affiliate link right here in the description down below. Thank you very much and have an amazing day.